you had the, somebody that's your first and last name, okay?
John Dobbs.
John Dobbs.
1974.
John, I'm Detective. Yeah. I'm Detective Phelan with the Orange County Sheriff's Office Homicide Unit, okay? This is Detective Talton.
Homicide.
Yeah.
We investigate all crimes of this type of level.
What level is this
one?
Stabbing people and cutting people, stuff of that nature. Mm-hmm. Assaults, batteries, and all that good stuff. Okay, John, this is what we got. I'm just gonna lay it out for you, okay? Mm-hmm. Right now, we got several people putting you guys, you and your girlfriend, at the dollhouse. Mm-hmm. Putting you being involved in a fight. Give me 1 second. Go ahead, sir.
But like he was saying,
yeah. I don't. Can they get in?
There's a fight that took place in the parking lot. Mm-hmm. Okay, and we already know all that. Okay, mm-hmm. And we're just here. Okay. We just want your side of the story of what happened. Mm-hmm. That's the only thing we want. You know, mm-hmm. There's a couple of guys we know that's been stabbed. Okay, so we just want your side of the story of what happened. All right, because there's always two sides to every story. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And we just want you to tell us what exactly happened here. Please, he can go. You just hold off right now.
Okay. And I know he was explaining, but basically this is where how it goes. We got the whole and all the witnesses. We're looking at you. You got blood all over you. We know you're involved in something. Mm-hmm. We don't know how it started. We got like one side of it. We got their side of what happened. Okay. We're here to get
you. Do they have surveillance cameras for the parking lot?
Yes, they do. Okay. But unfortunately for you, the surveillance cameras only cover the front half of the parking lot. The area where you were, no. Okay. The area where the fight occurred, no. So we got their stories, we got the people working there, and stories.
People working there, Sam.
We'll get to that. Okay. But I'm just laying this out for you. We got those stories. We got your girlfriend over here, we're gonna talk to her.
You got her name?
Yeah, she's here. And we get everybody's side of what happened. I mean, it's not that difficult.
It's not difficult at all.
Yeah.
Okay. I'm gonna tell you what
happened. Okay, first before I let you do that, I have to read you your rights. Okay, because this is a crime. And you do have rights, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna have to read those to you. Our whole intentions are to get your side, so we have both sides. Don't just arrest. I don't want to arrest a person just to be arresting because somebody said this happened. I try to look at both sides. Okay.
All right, been arrested.
Okay. You had a right. Well, you hadn't been taken over to the jail yet. You see what I'm saying? Okay. You had a right to remain silent. Do you understand that?
Yes.
You, anything you say may be used against you in court. Do you understand that?
Yes.
You had a right to talk to a lawyer before and during questioning. Do you understand that?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, as I was saying, my whole intention is to get your, I'm going to get your girlfriend's side, I'm going to get your side. I got their side of what happened. I don't know what started this. They are really pretty vague on what started this.
Of course.
Okay. So, what we're here is to get the whole story.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And with that in mind, do you want to tell us what happened?
We spoke inside the club.
I mean, y'all were inside, y'all met inside the club?
Me and one of the guys. I don't know the name, he got tattooed.
Can you describe
him? Ice cream kid tattooed on his neck. No.
What about his hair? Did he have long hair, short hair?
He looked like some kind of braid
thing. Like braids coming to the sides, you think?
No, I think it was more going up. Couldn't really, it was like real brief. I met him going out the door.
Okay. That's when you're leaving?
When we're leaving at the end of the night.
I said right before you exit, you met him?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. And what transpired there?
No, he was just questioning me about chicks, because my girl calls me daddy, and you know, we was playing around talking to the other, talking to the dancers that, and I was like, you know, my girl calls me daddy. He was like, oh, you got hoes, and I was like, nah, why everybody think that because somebody called me daddy that I got hoes, and you know. And then he just gave me a bad vibe, but I was just like, you know, leave him. So I went outside, and I guess they was plotting on me or something.
And when you said they, how many?
I mean, I seen them with at least 3-4 other guys.
Okay, and were they all outside the club when you got out, or were they?
Well, I was getting in my car, and they was getting in the car, you know, a couple of car measures away from me.
What kind of car
were they getting in? Mm-hmm. I don't know. I wasn't watching all that. I just heard them say something like, oh, you see, he got the security around him and he grabbed his girl and he left. You know, and he called me a player before, so I figured it was just gonna be a conversation. Mm-hmm. You know? So, I mean, basically, he said that and I was like, kind of thrown off. Like, you know, they was kind of laughing, so I was like, you know, maybe I'd say talk a little shit, you know. So I didn't exactly get in the car. I walked to the back of my car, but one of the guys started walking toward me fast. Then I caught the vibe, like, hold on, this guy looks like he wants to fight.
Is this the same one you were talking to inside?
No, this is just a different one. A big, heavy set one, right?
They all big. Do you recall how he was dressed?
He had a white tank top on. I know that much.
White tank top?
Yeah, I think he had a black shirt over it, but it was open at the top. Anyway, or something like that.
Okay, and as he approached you, what happened?
As he approached me, he looked like he was ready to fight. Okay. And that's when I said, hold up. I said, we're not gonna fight.
Where are you at this time?
Standing at the trunk of my car. Okay.
So you were getting in your car and you came around to the trunk area?
Yeah, you know, but I didn't realize his friend was gonna come over there.
So you were actually like in conversation or?
Well, you know, I heard what he said and I was getting ready to say, hey, yo, man, you know what I'm saying? There's plenty of girls that go around, whatever, you know, talk shit, whatever, you know? But then I seen this boy rushing towards me like, you know, like I said, man. So then the boy comes to me and I'm telling the boy like, yo, ain't gonna be no fighting or none of that shit, right? You know, my girl's already sitting in the car because I unlocked the door for her. And all of a sudden he hit me, boom. Like he came up to me and he just hit me, boom. And I'm like, where the hell is this coming from? You know, so I tried to back him up a little bit.
And now, when this guy hit you, did he hit you in the face?
Yeah, he hit me in the face kind of, but I kind of like moved a little bit. And it still hit me in the face though, you know. He still hit me in the face. Anyway, boom, you know. And I was dizzy after that. Like,
had you had anything to drink?
I mean, yeah, I had a drink.
How many different drinks?
One, two. I mean, one. As a matter of fact, I only had one.
What was it?
Heineken.
Heineken beer? Mm-hmm. Had you had anything to smoke, anything, any drugs that would alter your...
No, I didn't have anything. No drugs.
Anyway. Okay, so your recollection is clear what happened.
Up until the point where, I mean, the kid was banging me around like a rag doll. Understand?
This is the kind of stylish one?
Huh?
This is the one that stout, the first one?
Yeah, but all of them was bigger than me. Okay. I mean, you know.
So he hits you?
He hit me, bam.
You try to get space?
Well, you know, what it was like, he hit me, and it was automatically a fight. Like, you know, so I tried to, like, swing and back him off. And then I was thinking, like, you know, I'm going to have to hit this guy in his head. Mm-hmm. So I tried to hit him. And then, you know, I seen the other guys coming, you know. And that's when I had a pocket knife. I pulled it out. You know what I'm
saying? Where was that?
Where was the pocket knife?
In your front pocket?
It was in my back pocket. I had originally told them that it wasn't mine, but it was. Then after that, I couldn't remember nothing because the guy had me by my shirt and one of the big guys had me by my shirt. Because one guy came up, I remember that, and I was like, I looked at him, he didn't move. Mm-hmm. So I said, this guy's not fighting. And I said it out loud. Mm-hmm. So then I just, you know, boom, turn around. And I remember, matter of fact, yeah, my girl got out of the car because they was jumping on me. Mm-hmm. And she tried to push them off me, like, yo, get off of him, you know? And
did you see any of the workers or the bouncers or anything
out? I couldn't see nobody. Actually, I couldn't see nobody. I was blacked out. I mean, during the whole process, I was trying to grab, I was getting hit so many times, I was trying to grab focus, but I was still swinging with the knife. Okay. And that was it. That's all I could remember. That's all I could remember except for...
Miss, there's how many times do you think those guys hit you? If you had to...
Damn, I don't know, it was different people hit me at different times, but there was this one guy who really had me. He really had me by my shirt. He must have hit me, like, real hard. I can't remember, but I know it was way more.
Was he the first one that came at you?
Huh?
The one that had you by the shirt, is he the first one that came at you or one of the other?
I think he was the other guy. I think, he was another guy because he was the one, I think he was the one who I said is not fighting. And I turned around, turned my back on him. Mm-hmm. And then he was like, he might probably felt like a punk when I said that.
Do you know how he was dressed?
He had a tank top on too. But, as you know, I don't remember much, you know. All I remember is that I couldn't really see nothing, and they laid off me for a second. Mm-hmm. And it was a point where I was grabbing at some of their stuff, trying to grab, because I know they had the knife. They had a knife trying to cut me, you know what I'm saying?
You know which one had the knife?
I don't know.
Did they ever cut you?
Yeah, they cut my arm.
The left arm?
Yeah, the left arm, they cut it, you know. Matter of fact, that's actually, around the same time that I pulled out my knife. Because, I always consider myself with a fair knuckle game. But I don't remember a lot of stuff because it was like, I was surprised that I didn't get knocked out. Mm-hmm. Like every second, I was like, oh shit, I'm not knocked out. You know what I'm saying? That's all I could think
of. Have you ever been in a fight before?
I've been in plenty of fights.
Like, so you know, the surprise is like, after the first fight, you know that you can take a lick pretty good.
Yeah, I know I could take a lick. I was 40 years though, I'm 32 years old. I haven't been fighting.
I said you had been in scrap before, real fist knuckle down fights.
Yeah, when I was a kid,
Because I've been in a few fights, quite a few.
Any man probably has grew up anywhere in the urban society.
So
even in the
what I'm saying is, you were fighting the whole time. You were trying to keep them off you the whole time.
Basically.
I'm saying
they would have left me alone when they seen me with the knife.
Right. They didn't get you down.
No, they didn't get me down.
Okay.
I don't think so. Yes, I did. Yes, they did, because that's why my knee hurts. They did knock me down. See my pants like that? They got me down. That's when. They did knock me down. They knocked me down and my knee is swollen. I can't remember a lot of stuff because the way it was, I was taking the beating more. You know what I'm saying? And the only thing I could do is like get away from it.
Tell me this, when did you get the knife? When did you put the knife in your pocket?
When I put it back.
When did you put it in your pocket? When did you go in the club? Did you have it when you went in the club?
The knife?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a knife I used to use working construction. Mm-hmm. And I used to hang my jackhammer up. I worked construction for years, so, But you gotta do the rope, and sometimes you gotta cut the rope.
So I'm saying, you had it when you went in the club?
Yeah, I had it. I kept it on.
And they didn't search it when you went in the club?
No.
Is that something you always do, is keep your knife on you? You might have some trouble or something like that?
Basically.
Okay.
Because it's a legal knife. The police told me it was all right as long as it wasn't over a certain size.
Is that the blade that locks when you open it? Does it lock or does
it lock on its
own?
Okay. After it was over with, you got in your car.
After it was over with, actually, all I remember is trying to stay focused. Mm-hmm. That's the main thing that I remember, just trying to stay focused. So, because, you know, when the police took me out the car, mm-hmm. you know, and I was standing up, I just went, like, you know, I was about to pass out. I knew that I would pass out. I passed out before. So I knew that, you know, if I stay up, I'm gonna pass out. So I laid on the car and told them, I'm getting ready to pass out. Let me sit down. But now that, you know, I got my wind and stuff, I'm all right. So boom, okay, yeah, anyway.
Do you recall firing your gun?
No, I didn't fire the gun. I didn't fire the gun, it's not my gun. This is the point. The point is I didn't even realize I had the gun until I was already in the car and it was on my lap. And I was like, I must have grabbed this from one of them. And I was thinking, like, either I grabbed it off of somebody's waist or I grabbed it off the ground. Okay, so now, then.
So you're saying that the gun that you had is not your gun?
It's not my gun.
Do you know how that gun got into your car?
I must have brought it to the car, but I'm just saying I don't know how I got it in my hands.
So you're saying that gun may have belonged to someone else that you were riding with? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah, that's what I'm thinking. I'm thinking it probably belonged to them, and what I did was scare them off, and that's probably why they stopped fighting me when I grabbed it. I don't know why they stopped fighting me. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? So basically, I'm figuring it's that. I'm figuring, matter of fact, I think it's when I hit the floor that I grabbed it. But what I did was go to the car and I had it on my lap, mm-hmm. and I didn't know what to do with it. So I was just like, let me see if it's loaded. Mm-hmm. So I unloaded it, just concocted.
Is this why you were sitting still in the parking lot? Or had you already started to leave when you were trying to fool with a gun?
Excuse me?
Like the pistol, when you told me that you had the pistol, uh-huh. were you checking the pistol while you were still in the parking lot?
Why are you driving down the road?
I don't know. I don't know what instant I was doing that. I know, basically, made sure that there was nothing in it in the chamber. Mm-hmm. And I took the clip out, but then I had it sitting on my lap, and I was gonna, like, you know, wipe my handprints off of it.
Okay.
And then I was gonna, then I thought about giving it to my girl. I was like, no, I don't want her to touch it. So then what I did was reach over to the back and try to put it. So I was gonna put it somewhere. I said, let me try to squeeze it in between the seat and the back, you know. And that's it. And then when I got, you know, further down the road, the police stopped me.
So they stopped you at that point?
Do you recall?
You know, they stopped me, like, you know, they stopped me a while. I drove with it on my lap for a while. Mm-hmm. Because I didn't know if I was going to throw it out the window, but the car, as a matter of fact, it was a car that came up to me. And the car, you know, matter of fact, and I had the thing on my lap, and I was taking a clip out, and they see me taking a clip out, and they just, like, try to make a U-turn. It was a truck. It was a burgundy truck, mm-hmm. as a matter of fact.
So he was following me.
He was following me all the time.
Mm-hmm. And he said he shot at
him. I ain't shoot at nobody. Mm-hmm. I ain't shoot at nobody. Nobody shot at me. Yeah. And
so, you didn't even have a gunshot residue on your hand from shooting a gun?
No.
Okay, so you don't mind if we take a test to check and see if you fired a gun or not?
Of course not.
Hey, John, let me ask you. At the point where you pulled your knife out, okay, and you thought these guys were really going to beat you half to death, okay, at that point, do you recall when you pulled your knife out? You know, at the point you pulled your knife out, do you know if you stabbed someone then or you tried to cut someone then? Can you kind of explain that to me?
I know. First, I wanted to make sure that he seen it so he would have backed up. I know that much.
So, and the kid kept trying to hit your knife like this, and like this. Is that how you did? You just bought the knife up and like this?
Yeah, and then I tried to, like, you know, I wanted to hit him, but he was hitting me on this side. As a matter of fact, I remember the beginning. He was hitting me on this side, so I was blocking with my left, and I wanted to hit him with my right.
Okay. Okay.
And it came to the point where I was trying to hit him, like, I had the knife in my hand, but I was trying to hit him with my hand, actually.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? At the same time, I wanted him to back up, but he just wouldn't back up. So I guess I might have said, fuck it, like, and tried to swing at him, like, cut him. You know what I'm saying?
So that way, when you went to swing at him, you were actually going to hit him, but the knife cut him? Is that what you're
saying? Well, actually, I was trying to, like, you know, punch him, hit him type thing.
Yeah.
It wasn't like, you know, I knew I wasn't gonna get a good hit because my way my hand was positioned.
Uh-huh.
It was just like more, I just wanted him. I didn't think the whole thing was gonna be that serious. It just jumped off crazy for me.
So after so the first one that was there, he was trying to punch you from the left, and you had your knife here in your hand to right. So when you came around, you swung at him like that, right?
Yeah. First I swung at him like that. Yeah.
And then after
I kept getting hit, I just was swinging.
Okay, so you started swinging the knife back and forth?
Basically.
Now, did you ever, like, when you had the knife, I understand, because I've been in a couple of fights before, and if there's more than a couple of guys that's jumping on me, I'm going to be trying my best to try to get, you know, get these guys off of me. So, you ever recall when you made, like, a slashing motion, and then you stabbed someone?
Man.
Okay, look, you know, let me explain to you, because these guys have been stabbed in the chest, like a puncture wound in the chest, like when he was stabbed like that instead of cut. Okay? I mean, he's not dead or anything, but what I'm saying is he stabbed. Well, to tell you the truth, all three of them were stabbed in the chest. Okay? And what those guys are saying is that you stabbed him. Okay? And well, it's obvious that you did stab him.
I'm by my car. I'm standing by my car. They come from all the way over there. I'm getting hit. I don't know what I'm... I never stabbed nobody before. You understand? I just was swinging the knife. You understand?
Okay, let me ask you this. How many?
I didn't even know if I hit them right.
Right.
Okay. I thought maybe I was missing.
Sure, I understand. John, but you know, if you had to say, how many times do you think you stabbed those guys?
Oh my God, please, man. I don't know what the hell was going on, man.
Okay.
I don't know. I was barely able to stand.
Okay.
The only reason I was really probably standing because the guy was holding my shirt.
Okay, I've been to some fights before, okay, and I know with the fights going
That's
on,
it.
You got all this.
I don't want to talk about it.
I mean, you're excited.
I
said,
I don't
like
talk about it no more. I told you everything, man. I'm not going to put myself in that position. No more than it's already there.
Well, that's up to you. I mean, you can explain to us if you want to, but I'm here just trying to help you, man, is all I'm trying to do. But you know, these guys are
somebody's gonna help me, then they know, you know, the whole thing is self defense. They know that somebody else should be saying it's self defense or whatever. I don't know. But my father's a lawyer and I'm gonna figure something out.
John, okay, let me ask you this last thing. Now, when you went to your car, did you go and sit inside your car or were you standing out beside your car the entire time?
Before it started.
Yeah.
Before it started?
Yeah, when you first came out of the club, did you go to your car?
I think I was getting ready to sit down.
Okay.
And then, you know, they was talking. I didn't understand exactly what they said, so I got out, I stood up. Like, you know, I think I went halfway down. Okay. I think I just unlocked the door for my girl and went halfway down. And then I was trying to understand what they said, huh? You know, and then I was like, you know, my head hurting right now, but I think, yeah, I went halfway down, and then I, you know, stood up and, you know, entertained the conversation, whatever, went to the back. I should have never done that shit. That was a fucking worst mistake.
Yeah. So you went to sign, you're in your car, and then these guys started talking some shit to
you. They came up to me, you understand? They came up to me. I didn't come up to them, okay?
Okay.
It came up to me. I said, it's not going to be no fighting. I hope you ain't thinking it's fighting or something like that. Or I hope you ain't trying to fight or whatever. And, you know, the guy came up to me and I was like, you know, I'm trying to stow, you know, I'm a man like, yo, you know. And then he swung on me.
Out of those four guys, have you ever seen any of them before
tonight? I've never seen any. I've only been here. I only came out here to see my kids. I've only been here for 2 days.
And where is
I never seen them before.
Where you staying here?
I'm staying in the hotel, man.
Okay. And you've only been here 2 days?
I've only been here 2 days. I haven't seen my kids in about a year. And, you know, I was having a hard time you know, see him. So I went to go see him. You know, I went to go see him. And I spent the day with him after school yesterday, and I did that today. And I was getting ready to leave in a couple of hours, and my girl said, yo, let's go to the strip club. And I said, I remember there's one up here. And I went over to the strip club.
So you ain't have nothing planned on going there, just something that came up, y'all just...
Yeah, it just came up, and we wasn't even there for about, we was only there, we got there about 1:30 something.
So it'd be fair to say you've never seen these guys
before? I've never seen them, don't know them. I mean, the whole thing is like, you know, it was crazy to me.
What stopped you from getting in your car and leaving?
When?
When you were at your car and he started running his mouth, what stopped you from getting in your car and leaving?
I guess because I was bored. I was surprised the club was closing at 2:00. And you know, I figured, you know, we was just gonna talk shit. You know, I figured I was gonna introduce myself to more people. That's it. I figured I was gonna be social. You know, I figured I was gonna be like, you know, stand up dude, you know, they, you know, they saying something smart, you know, I ain't figured we was gonna get real serious. I mean, we grown men. What the hell we gonna do something like that? We don't even know each other.
Your girlfriend. Did anybody say anything out the way to her or anything, you know?
Nobody said nothing to her, except for when they was jumping me and she was pushing them. They like, get her. Matter of fact, that's when I started swinging the knife. That's when, because they said, get her. And I was like, what? You know, I tried to get somebody off, get somebody away from her.
And what's her name again?
Deanna.
Deanna?
Okay. Yeah. Because I already had the knife in my pocket. And I already, you know, was like, you know, curious. But I've been in situations like that before and nothing ever happened, you know. I didn't think nothing was gonna happen.
All right. Okay. I'm gonna talk to her real quick. Let's get back here. Need any water in here?
Yeah, I appreciate some water.
Just water?
Let me ask you something.
Yes, sir.
How long do you think I'm gonna be here?
A while. A while. We got to interview all of them and all that stuff. Still talking to the people out there at the club. Still about it. One of the guys is in real serious condition.
I knew, you know, I just left because I didn't want nothing else to happen. Mm-hmm. We can't start over, you know. That's the only reason I drove off.
Yeah, you can understand that. I mean, you know, you're leaving. I'm just saying, you know, at the beginning, get in your car and get straight.
You know, I mean, I was just like, yo, I ain't no punk. I can talk shit with the best of them. That's all.
Here you go, bro. No shit. I had to help for you.
Yeah. So you want to get out and talk shit, just shoot the shit?
I mean, that's what people been doing since I came down to the South, like most of the time.
Okay. Went a little farther than that, huh? Ran into her.
I don't know how long I was out there staying for, but I mean, the whole thing is just, it just jumped off crazy. Yeah. But, you know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't supposed to be here. Like, you know what I'm saying? I ain't supposed to be in handcuffs right now. If anything, you know what I'm saying? I mean, you know, the only thing is that I didn't call you guys. You know what I'm saying? That's the only thing.
All right, let's go see what's her status. Okay.
If I'd have called you guys, probably would I be in handcuffs if I called you guys?
Hard to say. You had a weapon, they didn't. That's what. We didn't find no weapon.
They didn't have no weapon? Then how the hell did they cut me?
Yeah, we gotta look at that. That's all part of it. I'm looking at it.
Yeah. I mean, I seen the weapon. I seen it. All I did was see it real quick, but I seen it. You know what I'm saying? That's why I kept, like, really kind of, like, focusing away from the guy that was punching me in my head so hard. I didn't even mess with him, really, because I couldn't, you know what I'm saying, really even pay attention to him.
Hey, John, you got a cell phone?
Yeah, I got two cell phones somewhere, probably in my property that y'all got.
So, can you tell me why you didn't call the sheriff's office when all this happened?
Man, I was just like, let me get the hell out of here, man. Then I was driving real slow, just stuck and thinking, you know? And then I was mostly thinking about that gun. I was like, you know, what I'm gonna do with this, you know what I'm saying? And then I was like.
So you were thinking of, you know, as far as the gun, you were thinking what you could do with the gun instead of calling the sheriff's office?
I was thinking about what am I gonna do with it, if I'm gonna keep it, throw it away, whatever, you know what I'm saying? I was like, you know, I was like, man, let me just go. And I was thinking about my blood that was dripping down my face. I had a lot of blood dripping down my face at the moment. And I was asking my girl if I need stitches and stuff like that. And she was like, yo, you might need stitches, let's go to the hospital, then you can call the police. And I was like, you know, I said, let me go to the hotel and look in the mirror first.
See, that's the other thing, because if you had a cell phone with you, I was wondering why you didn't go ahead and call the sheriff's office. I mean, if I had just been in a fight, I mean, as a practical person, and you appear to me to be a practical, you know, I mean.
Yeah, I'm a practical person, sure, but I'm not gonna lie, I've never called the police.
Sure, I understand that, but you know, you have to talk about, I can understand if you were just in a fist fight, but you know, there are some guys that's been stabbed.
Yeah, but I didn't even realize I was poking them. I didn't even realize that I was actually getting to them. You understand? As a matter of fact, I realized it at the last second.
Now, did you ever see any of those guys fall to the ground?
No, I didn't see nobody fall to the ground, except for at the end, I seen somebody holding somebody.
Okay.
I seen somebody holding somebody, and I was like, you know.
So after you...
As long as they're not messing with me right now, that's when I think that's when I got the gun, and I think that's when I decided, you know, as long as they back up off of me, I'm out of here.
Yeah.
And on the way out, I almost hit one of the valet guys, and I was like, you know.
John, let me ask you a question, though. When you saw the guy on the ground and the guy...
I didn't see anybody on the ground.
Okay, when you saw the guy holding the guy,
mm-hmm.
What crossed through your mind then?
What crossed through my mind?
Yeah.
Yo.
See, I'm just trying to set things up, you know, as to how you felt then.
I think it was like finally they wasn't on me.
So do you think this guy maybe hurt or something?
Man, I was pretty sure that, you know, he was hurt. But I was just like, finally they ain't on me. I'm, you know, let me get out of here. I don't know what the hell just happened.
All right, John. Thanks, man.
Yo.
Yeah, man.
Yeah, here's the bathroom.
Yeah, in just one second, I'll have someone carry you over there, okay, brother? I'll be right back, John.
You go to the bathroom?
Want me to go with you?
No, I got it. I can do anything crazy, right?
What?
I always ask. Some people, you know.
But you gonna leave them alone, dude?
Yeah, unless you really want me to. You have pain.
I
trouble you were talking. Tell I didn't get my help, you ain't trouble.
Thank you.
What kind of work do you do?
Well, right now, the music.
Music?
Mm-hmm.
Okay. DJ?
No.
Trying to rap.
I sell CDs.
Sell
my own CDs. Okay.
That a rental car?
No, I was a loaner from the company that my car is in the shop with.
Okay, so loaner.
got his dirty clothes. These, man, God, this is crazy, man. Crazy, man. Everything. What the fuck kind of life is this? Officer. Officer. Excuse me.
Yes,
how you doing? I was saying, is it possible that if I'm going to be out on the PV, that I can give my property to my girl?
Yes.
Yeah, I got on the PV?
Huh? Yeah, you're going to be charged.
I'm going to be charged with what?
Huh? Aggravated battery.
I mean, it's not obvious self-defense. I mean, where does aggravated battery come in? I'm getting jumped by 3-4 guys. I mean, where does that
you had every you were at your car.
I had opportunity to what?
Leave.
To leave, but I didn't know I had a problem yet. Do you understand that?
I'm trying to understand that.
Okay, I didn't know I had a problem. We didn't have words of conflict at any point in time. Do you understand?
Okay.
We had no words of conflict. I did not know I had a problem. Why would I leave? Mm-hmm. You understand?
And then I
didn't go towards them. I was at my car.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? I don't have the right to stand by my car. I mean, this is gonna ruin my life. It's gonna ruin my girl's life and everything. And I know that you guys gotta know that basically there's no way that I initiated anything.
You're in a parking lot, you guys get involved in a fight, you bring out a knife.
Hold up. I'm in the parking lot, I'm standing by my car, three guys start running at me. One of them starts walking to me fast, he swings on me, then the other one starts running at me. I thought it was more than three, I thought it was four or five guys.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And I'm getting hit so hard, I can't see what's going on. I'm just grabbing for what I can. You understand? And
I understand what you're saying, I'm just saying.
But what is the law about me, you know, because I've been locked up before for something I never did. You understand? And I was locked up for 8 months for that, before I could even make bail to be the in trial.
Mm-hmm.
You understand? Now, this is crazy, man, because, you know, I got my kids. I just now, for the first time, came out here to see them. Mm-hmm. I mean, in a while where I could see them, and I just got my relationship back with them. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
My rent is due. I'm going to lose my apartment. My girl doesn't have, you know, she doesn't know her way around here. She's totally dependent on me right now, you understand?
Right.
Now, basically, you know, you guys are allowing, I mean, I don't understand how it's aggravated. What'd you say?
Battery.
Because I'm getting the hell beat out of me and I'm just barely awake during the whole thing. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
I mean, where does it, what sense does that make? I mean, how do you do that? How do you judge that as aggravated battery? I mean, I wasn't even aggravated. It was all self-defense. As the moment that they stopped hitting on me is the moment that I got in my car and left.
Yeah, but based on all the facts of the case.
What facts?
The facts. The people that were there, the valet and everything.
Yeah, did they say?
Based on what you told me and based on what they told me, there was opportunity enough for you to leave. You said you weren't down.
Hold on. I told you they was holding me. I told you they was holding me, and that's probably the reason why I was standing.
Swinging too.
No, I was swinging with one hand. With one hand. I wasn't free swinging. I couldn't walk anywhere. I couldn't even see where the hell I was going. Half the time I'm bouncing off of my car. I was not in any position to leave at any moment before then, or else I would have ran. Come on now, man. Look at my face, man. You think I'm gonna sit here? I didn't come out here for this, man.
Hey,
I mean, listen, I don't know these guys. I don't know what they got. You know what I'm saying? The only thing I know is when I get what they got, they backed up or whatever for, you know, and I just went straight to my car. The moment I got a chance to leave, I went straight to my car. The moment. I didn't wait a second. I didn't discuss anything with anybody. I was not free to leave at any point before then.
Well, what I need to tell you, the one on dad, the one in critical dad.
Are you playing with me?
No. I'm serious.
Get the hell out of here, man. Listen, man. I had no point that I could leave, man. I had no point that I could leave, man. The moment that I had a chance to leave, I left. If I was firing a gun, believe me, I felt that scared that I would have used it at that point. None of that happened. You know, listen, man, I'm gonna lose everything I got. I'm gonna come out with nothing. And I don't really have anything right now. You understand? I got a couple of things that's supposed to be coming on TV for me rapping. That's it. I don't have any money from it, anything. My kids, I just made them promises and stuff that I was going to bring for. I mean, listen, this was, I don't know how long the fight went. It must have been about 2 minutes, not even 2 minutes. You understand? Mm-hmm. But I was getting, it was crazy at that moment. And I had no way to leave, man. I had no way to leave. And the only time that I could have left was before I decided to conversate with them. Mm-hmm. But I didn't go over there thinking I was going to fight them three big ass dudes. Come on, man. If you are the one who's going to say, yo, whether or not this case is aggravated battery, I mean, whatever, you know, I mean, if you're the one, I mean, You gotta know that, man. I mean, just listening to what they say, I know that the valet people didn't say that I had a chance to leave during the fight. During the conflict, once it started, I know they didn't say I had a chance to leave. Because they was, first of all, the only chance that I might have been able to run was the time when my girl was pushing one of them off of me, and I was trying to get them not to hit her. Mm-hmm. That was the only chance that I had an opportunity where I was free with both hands.
See, the thing is, you introduced a weapon into a fist fight.
A fist fight, man? I'm cut.
We have no weapon. None of them left.
How hard is that to lose a raise or whatever? Mm-hmm. I mean, how hard is that? I mean,
independent witnesses, they said no weapons other than yours.
No weapons other than mine. So what am I doing now? What am I doing? I'm standing outside my car, talking stuff.
You get in a fight with four guys, they're getting the better of you, and you pull your knife and go to work.
I mean, listen, their car was at least 15 feet away from me. They came to me. They came at me. You know, I'm standing there, and I don't know what's going on.
Let me tell you what she's going to do. She's going to document all your injuries. She's going to photograph you as you are, so that it all be on record.
And man, listen, man, you're ruining my life, man. my credit. I just got the car that they fixing right now to put a new transmission in. That's why I got the loaner. That's why I came out here to see my kids. I said, yo, I got a decent car to do some traveling with. Let me take advantage of this moment. You understand? Now, right now, you know what I'm saying? I mean, this is not the life I'm living, man. And you know what I'm saying? Y'all throwing me back in there. You know, I don't even know. I think that the guys that was there was regulars there, and that the valet parking people know them or something, man. I don't know, man. But I think that, because I heard people calling one of them by name. I don't remember the name or nothing, but I knew that they was in a familiar environment. I wasn't. You know what I'm saying? When I was leaving the club. But I didn't think it was going to be no problem like that. You understand?
And I understand that.
I wouldn't really even think that they... I think they see me with my girl. I didn't think they was going to come and try to jump me. I mean, who does that? Who does that as grown men?
As really stand here, I don't think you went there with any intention or came out with any intention to hurt anybody. But the situation itself...
With self-defense.
That's what you got to claim.
I got
the charges are right now aggravated battery, and homicide.
Now, how can you charge me with that? What do you do with a victim?
How do I not charge you? How can I not charge you?
How can you not charge me? I mean, you look at the evidence, you say, yo, I know that if you put everybody stabbed together.
Cut two of them, I know you stabbed one and killed him. So what else can I do?
Look, man, you can recognize.
I can let you walk.
You can recognize that I couldn't even see what I was doing. You can recognize that I could not even see what I was doing. Every time the kid hit me, one of the kids hit me, the other kid would hit me at the same time. Every time the kid hit me, the other kid would hit me at the same time. I couldn't even see. Do you understand being knocked out of the paintball?
We got that on tape. I mean, I got what you told me. And hey, trust me, I'm writing that down. But what happened? All the facts of it, I gotta write it up. Ag batter, homicide. There's no way around it. And that's the truth.
There's no way around it. That's no way around it. No matter what nobody's story is about how much it is self-defense, there's no way for you.
That is your defense.
That is my defense.
That's what you're claiming. Your defense is that they were beating you to the point that you had to do what you did.
I'm not gonna say that, you know, I wanted to hurt the guy like that. You know what I'm saying? All I wanted to do was get them to get away from me. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. Okay. She's gonna go ahead and get this done. I gotta go, a lot of writing to do. And we're still talking to her.
Oh my God, man, but this is crazy though. This is crazy, man.
That's what I'm saying. Usually situations like this are just a flick in your life and all of a sudden your whole life has changed. I mean,
but they gonna, you know what I'm saying?
You were somewhere, you weren't even planning.
Who the hell is gonna believe me, man?
Huh? I'm telling you sounded pretty convincing to me.
I can't afford nothing. You know what? I need to make a list of things for my girl to do. Is that possible? Because she has to go and get her life together, man. She don't got, okay? She got with me from a group home, you understand? Yeah,
let me tell you what.
She's been with me for 2.5-3 years right now.
Let me tell you what. As soon as she gets through and we get through with her, I'll bring her in here and let you talk to her.
You would?
Yeah.
Appreciate that, man.
All right.
Do you actually have a cut right here on your lower?
Everything is cut. It's not. I don't think it's just blood. It hurts when I touch it.
Okay.
I can't believe that kid got hurt. That's so fucking stupid.
All right, I'm gonna need you to stand up so I can take an overall picture, and then I'm gonna move in and document all your injuries. All right?
Uh-huh. I don't know. I was spitting blood, but I think it was just coming from my nose. So. feel like a girl on the TV. Lucy, are you all into? I mean, like right now, I still see spots.
Sticker scales that I'm going to put so I can get the size of your injuries, all right? Try not to hurt you too much.
You just telling me about that kid. You just told me.
Okay. Yep, stay still for a minute. Okay, I'm gonna get some clothes. Did you get cut through here?
I just mostly got bangs in my head.
Okay.
And cut them all off.
Yeah, I'll get that in a minute.
As far as I know, I felt a couple of other things, but they don't feel nothing right now, so.
All right, let me turn you around. Do we know, is there any way to pull them off?
Sure.
No.
Oh, no, I don't.
Here, I'll just take a picture of you. What about putting his hands, I need his hands in the front.
I don't know if it'll fit you. Right,
I'll go
second.
Okay.
Have you ever heard anything like this?
Hmm?
Have you ever heard anything? I'm being attacked. All these guys are bigger than me. And all these guys are hitting me. My head is going every direction. And I'm just thinking to myself, wow, another hit? I didn't go down? I mean, not that I didn't go down, but I'm not knocked out because it felt like I was getting ready to be knocked out. Yeah, and then I feel like I'm grabbing my consciousness. God, I can't believe this, man. I cannot believe this, man. This is crazy. This is crazy, man. You know.
He's gonna put your hands in the front.
Uh-huh. You know what's crazy? Also, I was just talking to my kids more, and she talking about my temper and stuff, and I'm like, man. You know what? I don't get down like that, man. You know, she told my son I did when I was 15. When she was 15. No, she pushed the thing in there.
Yeah, I know that. You gotta. So, well, I don't have to use this motor. So I gotta fuck
it. Is that thing coming off of my face?
Yeah, it's alright. That was done.
Wait, how you going? Yeah, this is just makes.
Actually, if you'll sit down, I'll go ahead and do your three full squats.
Good. That kid didn't really get nice. What the hell?
All right. I turn around.
And now I got people hating me now.
I turn around again, please.
Crazy, man. This is crazy, man. Yeah, send my baby brother.
Alright.
up here.
Oh, you're not gonna tell me, you're gonna put it back in the back again?
Just like that, alright? Okay, can you hold your hand up like this?
I didn't even know what I was doing, I know I was punching.
Like this, there you go. Hold it just towards me.
I ain't got the bloody hands.
Okay, can you hold it like that? Can you close the door?
You see, I told you they was cutting me, man. Yeah,
do you have anything on your knees? Do you know?
I believe so. I feel like when I hit the floor.
Okay, good.
Yeah.
Okay, can you scan them?
Just these claws right here, where they cut. Are you gonna take this off to check it or no?
I don't know. Can you get Dave?
These are cuts.
Yeah, I know. I just don't know if we'll be able to put it back on and what
the best way to do it. I need that on there if you're gonna take. You're gonna cut. Because they sitting here like these guys had no weapon on me and you know. Like they was fighting to justify a fight or something, whatever. Damn, man, I need my, oh my God.